Hi everybody, happy to meet you again with yet another important aspect of early childhood education. In today's session, we are going to discuss about the ways and means of reviewing and evaluating the planned themes and activities in an early childhood learning setup. As you all know, planning is very important for any activity and so do the evaluation part of it. Before moving on to the topic, we should be aware of the concept of early childhood education. Early childhood education can be defined as a process of offering opportunities or experiences for the children in the age group of 2 to 6 years in order to enhance their all-round development and also to provide support systems to families and societies to meet the developmental needs of young children. In this module, let us discuss about the themes and activities of early childhood education centers. At the end of this module, the listeners will be enlightened about the various approaches in early childhood education and equipped to select a curriculum based on the developmental needs of children. Children exhibit a very great enthusiasm in exploring, experiencing, and learning new things. Every day, they are ready to take up new learning by means of new experiences. The educators and administrators in the early childhood education centers are aware that appropriate teaching learning takes place effectively only when all the developmental needs of children are addressed completely. So, the main and wholesome objective of early childhood education is to provide activities and experiences that integrate all of the domains of development and thereby attending to the needs of the whole child individually as well as in groups. Pedagogy refers to the appropriate interactive process taking place between early childhood educator and the children in a conducive learning environment. There are different types of approaches in early childhood education. They are theme-based approach, activity-based approach, structured approach, and integrated approach. Now, let us see each of these approaches in detail. First, theme-based approach. It is a common approach applied by the early childhood educators all over the world. The main aim of this approach is to bring together a variety of skills and knowledge that has to be obtained by children and organize them into logical and specific themes such as nature, season, festivals, families, fruits, and etc. An intentional spotlight on a given theme makes the young children to acquire more proficient skills and processes vital to collect and practice information later in life. Now, a theme may be defined as a subject matter, which is explored in the early childhood classrooms in numerous methods. Theme-based teaching makes a child's learning to be focused on specific knowledge within the umbrella topic. It enhances their ability to make connections and to transfer knowledge and thereby to apply whatever they learnt in meaningful ways. Early childhood educators can use the theme-based teaching to engage the children in the learning process by providing a variety of activities from art and music, from readiness to dramatization, surrounding a common theme that is included in all content areas. Theme-based teaching learning approach in early childhood education helps in creating associations with the real world, construction on already existing knowledge, keeping children engaged by fun-based learning, allowing early childhood educators to create a valid teaching learning experiences, providing a choice for children to select what they want to learn, building a new vocabulary in natural settings spontaneously, allowing children to exhibit understanding in numerous ways. Next is the activity-based approach. Our day-to-day life is filled with activities. The same can be applied for early childhood education also. Excellent learning experiences can be provided for children through activities. This approach is based on the principle that real-life activities make the children to use various activities in all domains such as motor, cognitive, language, and social in cohesion. Activity-based approach encourages early childhood educators to implement the teaching process through various types of activities to achieve the desired outcomes. There are three different types of activities. First one is the planned activities. In this type of learning, the early childhood educators plan various activities to be implemented in the learning process based on the educational goals. These activities make the early childhood educators to procure all the essential materials for the planned activities and organize the classroom carefully to facilitate the children to acquire the skills and concepts related to a particular theme. Next is the child-initiated activities. Sometimes children will be attracted towards certain objects or incidents. Learning spontaneously happens through this. The early childhood educator can utilize this opportunity to teach certain appropriate concept to the children. Lastly, the routine activities. Daily routine activities like bathing, eating, grooming can be converted into learning experiences. In early childhood education centers, routine activities such as circle time, storytelling, eating lunch, toileting, outdoor play and gardening etc. offer many a learning experiences for the children. Next comes the projects or inquiry based approach. A project is an examination of a theme done by small groups or by individual children. The early childhood educators offer some activities like painting, printing, sand play, and then observe the children. The children will design their own way of approaching the given activities and in the process pose a lot of questions, narrate incidents, and try to accomplish the desired activities through trial and error basis. With variety of materials, the early childhood educators enable them to make their learning clear through drawing or painting or molding or story recitation. Next comes the integrated approach. In this approach, children's learning occurs in an integrated and holistic model. Teaching learning process is not compartmentalized into domains like physical domain separately, cognition separately, or creativity separately. A child is viewed as a wholesome individual and catered to their needs. To conclude, an early childhood education program should be executed in a child-centric manner. It is mandatory that the holistic approach should consider the learning of the child not only as what the early childhood educator transacts in the classroom, but also as created by the children within the frame of their natural and social environment.